what happened to political philosophy and the theories of philosophy. After Al-Farabi, however, some people like Hassan Ziyai, that Professor Balbij worked with him, they try to say that, yes, from Sohrabardi's philosophy, there are some philosophical, political ideas that some other, they try to use those ideas. But generally, it is, you know, the question is that why not that explicit as Al-Farabi tried to do so. However, we have some scholars in the course of Islamic history that they try to write on Nasihatul Muluk, advising those kings and on how to do that thing, how to govern, and things like that. But still, no such per se political philosophy. Maybe one of the reasons, we should think about it, maybe one of the reasons was that because in the Islamic history there was the caliphate idea, at least among the Sunnis, or there was the idea of imam among the Shiites, and probably that, so and for Shiites, imam, the being of imam was the ideal type of governing, and so probably they thought that they don't need to philosophize about this. This is one possible answer to that question, but maybe the other answer is that most of this philosophy after Al-Farabi with Ibn Sina and others moved from natural philosophy into more metaphysical philosophy. So that's being a reason that some philosophers say that metaphysical and talks and notions has nothing to do with, political philosophy and philosophizing about the government. But let's come to the kind of contemporary time and discuss to modern philosopher, again, among the Shiites, and again, inside the Shia seminary, but both of them in Iran. First, I start with Allama Tabatabai. Tabatabai is known for being a philosopher. He has written books on philosophy. He's famous. His books are taught. And currently is being taught in Iranian universities, in Iranian seminaries, and even originally in Arabic language, translated and taught in some other countries. So also he's known as to be an exegesis to the Islamic scripture, Quran. He has more than 20 volumes of commentary on Quran. Is famous because, especially in his method, first he being philosopher, his commentary on Quran was sort of, if we can define it, rational interpretation, or what they call it, tafsir aqlani, or intellectual interpretation. But then he uses, in order to interpret Quran, he uses Quran to explain Quran. I mean, usually in the tradition, they use hadiths to explain Quran. Hadiths are those narratives of prophet and other imams. But he tries to say that the text itself must explain itself, and then he goes to, like, referencing for one verse from another verse, and then he tries to make his commentary. Also, he was known for theology and other usual subjects in the seminary, like fiqh, and as well in mysticism and Sufism. He has important works on Sufism that are translated into the other languages as well. So, as well, we can talk about Allama Tabatabai as one of the masters of tradition of philosophy among the Muslims or among the Shiites, who was a continuous change, who was a peak in a continuous chain of the philosophers. So it goes, his masters and the chain of the masters are clear from him back to time of Avicenna. As well, he was well known of those philosophers and thinkers who teach that there is a harmony between intellect and revelation, despite the other group oppositions that they think that there is absolutely no harmony between intellect, reason, and revelation. So, wanted to let you know about Tabatabai, and he also explains his mission as when he tried to, because usually they were going to from Iran to Iraq and the city of Najaf. There was a seminary in Najaf, very famous for Shia scholars. And then he went there, he studied there, he came back to Iran, he went to his home, Tabriz, and then finally to Qom. And when he goes to Qom, he explains that when he reaches to Qom, he finds out that there is a lack of intellectual sciences and knowledges in that seminary. And then he tries to establish a course on intellectual sciences or knowledges like philosophy. Or also, he says that I found out that the interpretation of a scripture was seen as a low level work. So, but he spent a good time to write his voluminous interpretation of Quran. But so going back to his philosophy, political philosophy, the point is that again about Allama Tabatabai, the question is whether he was a political philosopher. Many people may say that no, he wasn't, because he didn't write an especially extra and specified book on political philosophy. He wrote about philosophy, he wrote about religion, he wrote about many other things, but not about utopia, for instance. So, but in another way, we can say that in his different works, he is giving his idea society. He is giving his ideas about governance and things like that. One of the books, like for instance, Al-Mizan, being interpretation of the Revelation. He talks about, and there are other some treatises that he works and he talks about political philosophy. But what I am trying to say and to do here is that I'm talking about two Muslim Shiite philosophers whose talk on political philosophy is different from what Khomeini's Vilayat al-Faqih was trying to present. So one of them is Allama Tabatabai. And let me say that what is Vilayat al-Faqih is that the guardianship of jurisprudence. So it means that he being a kind of having the authority over other people, and people have to obey him because he is faqih and because he is knowledgeable in religion. So that's the general definition of Vilayat al-Faqih. But the idea is that, what about these philosophers? What they have to say about the idea of Khomeini, of Vilayat al-Faqih, or however they didn't encounter him harshly, but they had another ideas. So, because he is a philosopher, he starts from philosophy. He tries to say that there are some ideas in philosophy that he calls them realities and constructs, or what in Arabic haqa'iq and i'tibariyat. He means that he tries to say that, hey, listen, philosophy, governance is something which is created by people. how to do this. It is not a metaphysical discussion that we talk in, you know, because Khomeini's ideas of Wilayat al-Faqih is kind of religious, metaphysical idea which comes from. The idea among for Allama Tabatabai is not like that. He says that governance is an i'tibariya, something that people should think about it because it's a matter of their life and decision. And let me go back here. he has a chapter, governance and leadership. However, he argues first of all that it's necessary to have governance, and then so he says that it's natural, that it's in the fitra or disposition of every human being, and they accept to have a governance. And then the question is that who should lead the society? The individual, and who excels others in administration, in, you know, science, knowledge, everything. But the point is that whether this person must be a faqih or not, that's the question. Also in Al-Mizan, let me grab the exact wording of what he says. He uses Quran again to show that how what's the Islamic idea about the governance is. He says that in Quran you have terms that calls people like aqimu bil qist. He says that establish justice. And then the point is that the Quran doesn't talk to some specific person. It talks to all people. Do this. If you want to make a governance, make aqimu bil qist, establish justice. So it's a duty upon all people. So, and then he goes again to say tasleet al kull ala al kull. So again, what is this establish justice? He says that this is the authority of all to all. So everyone has a share in the power. And again, there are some other Quranic verses he referred to, Al-Mu'minun ba'zhum awliya wa ba'z. And so, yeah. And so the idea is that, he tries to make it not a person as faqih, but he tries to interpret it as all to all. And then it defines as how all to all. It goes to ideas like democracy, ideas like, I'm not going to discuss those things. I don't have time to talk about what the similarities and differences he has with Al-Farabi. The ideas he was using philosophy as basement of the idea of making governance, and then he was trying to as well introduce another idea, which was at-taslit al-kull ala al-kull in Arabic, which means that the authority of all to all. And then he goes to discuss in detail about how it does it. And he also brings evidence from the Islamic perspective.